All right, now we're ready. Silas got the massage gun. Give me more of that thing. Sharing is caring. All right, let's get you all moving. So for our 5-minute warm-up, we're going to do 5 different movements for 1 minute each movement. And I promise you will be nice and warm once you get done with this. So we're going to start out with hands overhead good mornings. So Silas has got his arms locked out beside his ears, slight bend in the knees, and then that nice long flat back. He's going to push his hips back, get a big hamstring stretch. But I want you to try to not let your arms fall forward as you come down. Work on keeping those right by your ears. So we'll start out with that. We're going to go 1 minute straight on that. So let's go ahead and get started. 3, 2, 1, arms up. Let's get it. I think you'll find these are actually kind of challenging if you're going to keep those arms right by the ears. There we go. So you're just driving the hips straight back. There you go. Slight bend in the knees, nice flat back, push back on those heels. And every time you go down, you should feel some pretty significant tension in that upper back from trying to hold those arms up. That's how we're going to wake you up today, because we've got a lot of work to do with our shoulders today. Everybody's looking solid on this. I'm seeing good neutral spines. Long arms. Keep going. We got about 15 seconds left on this one. All right, next one we're going to move into is a pulse squat. So we're going to sit down super deep into that squat. Feel free to spend some time down there if you want to, but otherwise, you're just going to come up halfway and then drop right back down. So you can see Silas rolling through that. There you go. Should have those feet a little bit wider than the hips, so make sure we're not too narrow. There we go. Feel free to sink down, shift side to side a little bit, but don't spend too much time down there because we do want to heat you up with that pulse with dropping down and dropping back up. So play around with that, mix it up. You got about 30 seconds left on this particular movement. And then we're going to roll into some slow mountain climbers. Got about 10 seconds left. There you go. All right, we're going to move to the next one right into a tall plank. Bringing those knees straight up the center, slow and controlled. And we're going 1 minute straight on that. So try to stack the elbows straight above the wrists, shoulders straight above the elbows, and slowly bring those knees up towards the chest. Got it. That's it. I'm gonna warm those shoulders up. They're gonna be ready to go. 1 minute's always a long time to hold these tall planks. Keep going. Just focus on that ground beneath your hands. Bringing those knees up slowly. We got about 25 seconds left on this one. Let's see, we got Kay and Christine. What's up, ladies? Out in the sunlight as always. That's the best place to be. All right, we're going to roll that right into a straight leg inchworm. So if you notice, Silas is pretty much keeping his knees straight, so he gets that massive hamstring stretch. And then he's walking his hands out, adding the push-up in. We are warming up, so we're going to get that push-up in. We got some of those coming up later. Drive the elbows back and keep them in tight on those push-ups. That's it, folks. That's it. Keep it up. Got about 20 seconds left on this one, and we got one more movement we're going to go through for this warm-up. Oh, see those weighted push-ups, buddy. You better get back up. All right, let's go ahead and stand up. We're going to go in our I's, Y's, and T's. So we'll start with the I. Thumbs up, straight elbows, hinge back, and then bring the arms up by the ears, and then right back down by the hips. So remember, you're going to have your arms right by your ears on this, so we're not going out wide. Try to keep those arms at shoulder width apart. We kind of had everybody start at different times, so we're going to go about 5 seconds longer on this one, and then we'll move into that Y. All right, we'll take it out wider now. We're doing that Y, so just a little wider than you were with the eyes. About 10 seconds, we're going to go into our T's. So right now, we're still in the Y's. All right, let's do those T's. So you're going to see Silas lead with his thumbs and pull all the way back like he's doing the top of the letter T. Big shoulder blade squeeze here. What's up, Michelle Niebuhr? I don't see Brody running around anywhere. Got him out. Got him out of the house. All right, go ahead and take a break. Everybody's going to need a dumbbell for this first part. So this is a new movement. We are calling this the Silas birthday ladder. We're going to ladder up. We're going to start at one. Then the next set, you'll do two. Next set, you'll do three. Silas turns 21 today. He's going to have his first beer. He was early with his beard. All right, so we're calling this a plank step back into a dumbbell floor snatch. Floor snatch. I'm not sure why the word floor. I guess it's coming from the floor. So he's going to step back and then step up and then put two hands on that dumbbell and go all the way up the front of his body. If you notice, when he brings this dumbbell up, he's keeping it very, very close to the front of his body, and his elbows are bending. He's not swinging. This is a snatch. The first round, he did one rep and then walked back. The second round, he walked back and then did two reps. And now he's on his third round, so he's walking back up. And now you're going to see him go through three double-arm dumbbell snatches. So he's really relying on his legs for that, letting his arms just guide that bell or that dumbbell up and keep that core nice and tight throughout. So it's a ladder. You start with one. Then you step back, step up, do two. Step back, step up, do three. And you just keep adding one rep every round. We've had some folks, if they had a little bit lighter weight, got all the way up past like 15 reps, getting close to 20. I went with a really heavy weight. I got like through 11 and barely got into 12 by the end. So it really just depends on what weight you're going to use. Stephanie White this morning, I know she got past 15 and she was using a 25-pound dumbbell. So I'm going to give you about a minute to go ahead and get some practice on this movement, especially if you've got something lighter you want to practice with and then you want to move up in weight, you can. And then we will go right into it. It's a 5-minute AMRAP. So it's as far as you can get on that ladder in 5 minutes. So go ahead and practice. You put the dumbbell on the ground, walk back 1 foot, 2 foot, walk up 1 foot, 2 foot, and then snatch that sucker all the way up. Start with one, and then walk back and up, and then you do two, all that good stuff. We'll get about 30 seconds longer on that practice. You kind of have to play around, find your best grip on that dumbbell. I was switching with which hand I had on top as I went through it. You can absolutely rock that with a kettlebell if you want to, too. Just be careful not to let it swing too low whenever you come down in between. Like, that'll pretty much just turn into that American-style swing, which is really a snatch. You're keeping it close. Cut this thing off. It's starting to heat up. That's amazing. All right, so let's go ahead and get ready. It's been about a minute. Hopefully, you got that dumbbell ready to go. My hands are like loose feeling. All right, so we got 5 minutes, as many times, as many rounds as you can, adding one rep every single round. In 5 seconds, we're going to get going. 3, 2, 1. All right, crank up the music. Let's go. So walk back, walk up, one dumbbell snatch. Place it on the ground, walk back, walk up, two dumbbell snatches. And the same thing, walk back and walk up, and you got three dumbbell snatches. Go, Jay. We just started. We're like 30 seconds in. Walk back, walk up, get one. And then now you just walk back, walk up, and get two. Everybody's looking solid. There's a couple different ways you can approach this. I mean, you can go all out, or you can try to find a pace you can maintain. It all depends on how heavy that weight is. Remember, we're only going 5 minutes here. This is the main portion of your cardio today. This would be the yellow and red zones if you got a my zone belt, but it's up to you in terms of how much effort we put forth in that as far as where you get. But after this, we've got some strength work, and we got another METCON that's not going to be quite as intense as this one. It's just longer. That's it. Keep rocking. Woo! Silas is already tired. Y'all aren't tired yet. Let's go. Diana got the 35. I like what you're doing right there, MC. That looks good. Just walk back, walk up. Keep those feet out as wide as you want to. Keep being smooth on that jump squat. Yeah, Niebuhr looking good. Whiteley's looking smooth. Chris Frost, I'm digging the double dumbbells. Just keep it up. Keep it up. Let's go now. Oh, I see Polly Marie got on the live. Checked it out. Comment. I'm glad you did that recorded session, Polly. That's awesome. All right, we are 2 minutes deep. We got a little bit less than 3 minutes left. Let's get him, Coach Jay. There you go. Everybody's looking good. I don't know what Silas is doing. He's just standing around. 2.5 minutes left. Got rid of the 60, huh? You know, that shoulder thing's not going to be an excuse forever, Silas. Sword looking smooth. Let's keep it up. Remember, you're adding a rep every round. I wonder if Christine and Kay decided to match colors on purpose today. There we go. Got a lower creech. Got a lower creech. Come on. Y'all remember, every time you put the dumbbell down, it doesn't have to be sitting on the ground just right. You can just grab it and go. I know how that feels. I wanted mine to be facing a certain way the whole time. You know, you got to readjust. You got to get that extra breath in. Yeah, come on. We're not tired. Everybody's looking fresh, looking smooth. Only, so now you're past 90 seconds. You got less than 90 seconds left. Let's keep it up, keep it up, keep it up. I know you can do it. Jay looking smooth, looking athletic. Keep it up. Keep pushing. Come on, Foster. Come on, Foster. We got it. You get to catch your breath on that bottom part. Good work, Niebuhr. I like that good control overhead. Remember, you got something light you can really get after. If you got something heavier, probably going to try to find a pace you can maintain. But I would fully expect to see everybody getting in that yellow, if not up into the red with your MyZone belt. All right, 40 seconds left. Let's go. Let's go. 40 seconds. Come on now. You can do it. All right, 30 seconds now. 30 seconds now. Let's keep it up. You're almost there. Creech, I'm digging the kettlebell. Good stuff. Got that, Chris Frost. Come on now. Almost there. Keep doing what you're doing. You got 5 seconds. Everybody can get a couple reps in. All right. Rest. Good job. I'm going to give you about a two-minute break. Once we get down a minute, we'll go ahead and start explaining the next part. If you have done the bed sheet rows before and you have that set up, we do want you to use that. If you don't have that and you have a suspension trainer like a TRX or something of that nature, we're going to be using that next. If you do not have a suspension trainer, then we're going to give you dumbbell options or band options. So we're going to give you lots of different stuff. Let's just do since we know most people have – oh, make sure you enter your rounds in on Train Heroic. That's what Shia Silas is showing you. Apparently, he got to 13 rounds. Oh, you had to get – well, you did a 50. I'm not kidding. It's good stuff. So make sure you track how many rounds you got. Is it really? Is it Stephanie? I swear she got to at least 50. All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and show you what we got coming up next. So I'm going to get it up on the top right of the screen because you're going to see us move the camera on this so that you'll be able to see Silas. So give me just a second. All right, about there. All right, so just want to move that for you real quick so that you'll be able to see Silas using our suspension trainer over here around the way. So we're going 10 minutes. First movement we're gonna do is a lateral bear crawl. So our goal here, if you're a member, you know how wide our turf is. If you're on Facebook following along, you might not. So our turf is roughly, it looks about like 5 yards. If I remember correctly, when we had it installed, it was right around 12 feet. So if you've got a distance around that amount, we're gonna go 4 reps on this. If you gotta go shorter, you're gonna do 5. So on the lateral bear crawl, he's going to drop down, get his knees about 2 inches off the floor, and he's going to walk sideways. He's going to go across, go out of screen, and then come back. So that is 1 rep. He's going to do that 4 times with that distance. We put 4 to 5 on the screen. So if you got a little bit shorter distance, you can go 5 reps on that. Then he's going to pop up, go into an athletic stance, super fast basketball side shuffle down and back. Is also 1 on that, and we're going to do 4 to 5 on that, depending on what your distance is. Silas is going to be going 4. Then we're getting into our rows. So this is where I said if you have bed sheets, you tie them in big, heavy knots, put them through the top of your door, and then you hang it off the door, wrap your arms around it, and you can row like Silas is going to row with this suspension trainer. So we want to get you at a good, deep angle, and then he's going to pull for 20 reps. Most of us are not going to have a ton of weight on that, so we want to recommend that 20 rep range. If you're going real horizontal with it, maybe 15. If you do not have a suspension trainer, you can use 1 kettlebell or 1 dumbbell. If you have 2, definitely use 2. But if you got 1, you're going to go 15 reps on each side on a bent over row. Now, if you want to challenge your core like you do similarly on a suspension one, don't use that single leg support. Go to the position Silas is in now, and you can pull that from the center, or you can go a narrow stance and pull from the outside of your leg. So that's your options. If you do not have any weights on that, the one option you got is soup cans or a bent over motion with that T shape. So he's going to just demonstrate that real quick. So if you got anybody who does not have weights, it's just that T movement where you're squeezing those shoulder blades together. So lateral bear crawl, side shuffles, rows. Then we got 10 hand release push-ups. So he's going to drop down, hands is off the ground, pop right back up, maintaining a ton of tension through that midsection throughout all 10 repetitions. So that's what we got today. If you need any modifications on that, feel free to put it in the chat. Otherwise, we're going to roll through that for 10 minutes straight. Your goal is at least 5 rounds on this. You should be into that 5th round on this session. So I'm going to get this clock set, crank the music back up. Hopefully everybody is ready. Y'all ready to go? I see some of y'all still kind of up at your computers. I just want to make sure you're ready to rock. Heck yeah, that works, Misty. Yeah, if you want to do some barbell rows on that, you are welcome to. If you got a barbell. Otherwise, let's get ready in 5 seconds. Lateral bear crawls down and back 4 times, a good 10 to 12 feet. We get it. This will actually turn out to be the hardest part of the whole circuit is these lateral bear crawls. There we go. Got to keep those knees about 2 inches off the ground. There you go. Remember, 4 rounds down and back. 4 rounds. Good stuff, folks. Let's keep rocking. Keep pushing now. Keep pushing. Come on. As soon as you get done with those four rounds, you're hopping up and you're going four rounds on the side shuffles. Oh, we got the Wiley side shuffling together. That's what I'm talking about. We can turn that into a shadow drill. There you go, Jay Shoot. I cannot believe you don't have volleyball hands out on your side shuffle. The first volleyball play I've not seen. Like, there it is. They always stick their palms out every single time. Jay? Yeah, Jay was volleyball. All right, once you finish up on that side shuffle, you're moving into your rows. So let's make sure you got that back nice and flat if you're doing a bent over row. And remember, you're going to challenge yourself 15 to 20 reps on that per side. Silas is going to crank out 20 on his suspension trainer row. God, I hope Christine was about to do rows on the hammock. That would have been pretty cool. Are you doing it? I can't see her, but I think she is because I see a repetitive swinging motion of the hammock. When you get done with those rows, you're moving into your 10 push-ups. Hand release push-ups. Oh, there you go. I like the seated band row, Jay. Looks good. All right. We are 2 minutes in. 2 minutes in. Let's keep it up. Remember, we got four movements. Everybody should be getting close to the end of that first round, maybe moving into your second round. I like the push-ups, Chris Frost. Good elbow placement. MC, that's a good position. Good flat back. All right, once you finish up with your push-ups, we are right back into our lateral bear crawl. So that's a challenging transition. So if you got to rest briefly, go ahead and do it. But remember, when you get back into those lateral bear crawls, we keep those knees bent. So we don't want to see you straighten your legs out and go into a lateral plank walk. Missy's got the volleyball hands out. I see him. Got that, Diana. Come on. Tight, tight, tight. Let's go. Yeah, down and back four times. And as soon as you get done, you're back into that side shuffle. Four times down and back. We expect a full sprint when you're done with the side shuffle to wherever your rows are being done. You got to sprint. Good hustle all around. Good job, Misty Sword. You too, Michelle Niebuhr. That's a good distance you got going there. I see your dog. I bet he's getting some love when you're down there on that lateral bear crawl. Yeah, here we go. Here we go. So remember, once you get done with your lateral bear crawl side shuffle, then we go to our rows, whichever version you are doing, depending on if you have equipment or not, or a suspension trainer or not. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Keep rocking. Come on now. Good work, folks. Good work. Pushing high reps on those rows. High reps. Let's get it, Foster. Have a girl. That's it. Good work, Jay. Christine, are you doing like inverted rows on the hammock? Nice. Got to get a picture of that. You better tell Dave to come out and take a picture. If he comes rolling out, tell him to get his phone out. Got it, Diana. You got that. Come on. That's good weight. Oh, look at Jay. I see you. Hey, if you want to get off your back, you could always do like a standing band press. Wrap it under those armpits. MC, are those push-ups feeling good? Back's okay? All right. Let's go, Sword. That a girl, that's it. Let me get Brandon out here. Looking fast on those side shuffles, Chris Frost. Looking speedy. You got it. Oh, get some weighted push-ups. Tell her to get on your back. There she goes. Tighten up, Diana. Oh, you killed that. Just stay real tight. Squeeze them abs as tight as you can. Good job, MC. Good job. I hope you got some grips on those socks. Don't fall down. Let's go, Coach Silas. All right, folks, we are well past that halfway point. So you got 3.5 minutes left. Just keep pushing. You should be at a good, consistent heart rate with this. It might go up a little bit during the bear crawl and the side shuffle, then come back down somewhat on the rows and the push-ups. But overall, it should be relatively consistent. Remember this guy demonstrating here. It's his birthday today. If you get a chance, tell him happy birthday. Oh, killing it, Michelle. Keep it up. Digging it. Digging it. It's hard to breathe on those rows, doesn't it? Just like it's almost like a rack position. Everybody's looking solid, man. You're grinding away right through it. That's all you can do. 2.5 minutes left. Oh, I love the weighted lateral bear crawls. Always got to put your kids to good use. Diana, she's got her kid. Oh, and on the side shuffle. Let's go. Good job. Everybody's doing a really great job keeping their knees close to the ground on that lateral bear crawl. Let's keep that up, even as you get real tired. 2 minutes left. It's a good way to let your shoulders rest. Come on with it now. Come on with it now. Let's go. Just good, consistent movement. 10 minutes straight. That's it. That's it. All right, now 90 seconds left. 90 seconds left. Keep going. You got it. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo.
That's it. That's it.
Come on now. Minute 10. A minute 10. You can do that. Come on. Come on. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. Let's go now. All right. We got less than a minute. You do not stop when you got less than a minute left. We keep it going. Keep grinding away. Keep pulling. If you're pulling push-ups, keep pushing. If you're going sideways, let's get sideways. You got this. There you go. There you go. Come on. 20 seconds. Keep it up. If you're lucky, you might get back to your lateral bear crawls. Almost there, guys. 10 seconds now. All right. Rest. Good work. We'll give you about another 2 minutes just to take a break. Appreciate everybody pushing the pace on that. We're going to get into this next part shortly. There we go. Made that a little shorter. So just keep getting some water, take a break. We'll be moving into the next part of the session. I'm going to put this camera back where it was. Good to go. Oh, yeah. You said the clock fits right between the text and my head. All right. Game time. We're going to show you what we got coming up next. So you see it up in the top left of your screen. We're going to go through some core work. This for this, you're going to need like a moderate weight dumbbell or a kettlebell if you have it. If you don't, you could bring your hands together and move those quickly as we go through this. We'll show you what we're talking about. So we're going to go two rounds on this. Each round is 3 minutes long. Between each, after 3 minutes, you're going to get a 1 minute break. So the way this will work, we'll go 3 minutes on, 1 minute off, 3 minutes on, and then we're going to move into our stretching for the day. So each round is going to start with a 1 minute low plank. So that's on those elbows. You're going to engage the glutes. So tilting that pelvis a little bit, that's going to make your back nice and flat, but you'll feel them abs fire up as well as your glutes. Hold that for 1 minute. Then for the remainder of the 3 minutes, you have three core movements we're going to go through. The first is a world's greatest sit-up. So on this, you start from that hollow body position, as you can see Silas is. He's bringing his arms forward. And if you get real tired, you can just grab your knees right at the top of that. If you need to modify on that and you cannot go long legs, you can always do bent knees and just do a small crunch and kind of reach for those ankles as you come up. So that is 10 reps. That's it. Then you're going into a hollow position or staying there, going 10 bicycle kicks. So only 5 each leg, but notice he's going nice and slow. He's not flying around or flopping on his back like a dog scratching their back. Real slow on that, like much slower than normal. The number of repetitions you do on something like that doesn't really matter. It's all about time under tension. So we can go slow, we can go fast. We're going to go slow today and do 5 each side. Then when you finish that, we're going to come up to a kneeling position. So on both knees with the toes dug into the ground and those glutes engaged. That's what Silas was doing right then when he patted himself on the butt. Then you're going to go from one hip with the elbows bent all the way across to the opposite shoulder. So picture you're shoveling dirt or tossing something over top of your shoulder. And he's doing this. You notice he's making a face because he's holding a lot of tension through his abs, through his whole midsection, really. And he's moving that dumbbell. And that dumbbell wants to pull him around, whether it's going down, whether it's going up. So it wants to make him twist. We want you to resist the twist, just like we do in our Renegade rows. No twisting on this at all because we got both feet on the ground and we can't pivot our hips at all. So no twisting, but a fast, powerful movement of the dumbbell on that lift and chop or chop lift. So 10 each side there. The expectation here is to do your 1 minute plank and then within 2 minutes to get all the way through the world's greatest sit-up, the bicycles, and the lift and chop, and get back past those world greatest sit-ups again within about 2 minutes. So let's get set up. Let's get ready. We're going to start with a 1 minute low plank. If anybody needs to modify on that, let me know. If we're working around, like if that low plank position for a minute doesn't work for your back, we can always do 30 seconds on one side and 30 seconds on the other side with a side plank on that and just hold. So we're going to get going here. I'm going to crank the music back up. We're going to go in 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, plank. All right, I don't want to see any butts up in the air. We want it nice and flat. Oh, we got some solid-looking planks here, folks. If you're doing it right, you'll feel a ton of tension in your abs. If you feel it all in your shoulders and none in your abs, then you're probably hanging kind of lax, kind of loose. We don't want to do that. I want you to think like you're tucking your tailbone between your legs. You're going to immediately feel those abs fire up when you do that. Already 30 seconds in. Just going to talk you through the 1 minute plank before we get into those world's greatest sit-ups. Remember, we got the elbows stacked beneath the shoulders, straight beneath. You got about 15 seconds longer on this. Hold tight, hold tight. Just pre-fatiguing those abs. All right, go ahead and flip over right into 10. World's greatest sit-up. Remember, we always start this from the hollow body position. Come on. Oh, oh, grab them knees. There you go. If you have to, there you go. Throw your arms into it if you're really fatigued. And you can do it without throwing your arms forward, and you can keep your hands behind your head with the elbows back. Give that a shot. It's just a little more work on those abs. Then you're going 5 slow bicycle crunches each side. There you go, MC. So we're going to do that lift chop, and then you just did those alternating shoulder touches. Let's just focus on those two. Go 10 shoulder touches each side and that lift chop 10 each side. You go 2 knees on the ground this time. There you go. Dig your toes in, squeeze your glutes tight, and just move that up across your body. And just make sure you don't allow yourself to twist or turn at all. Silas is going through that right now. 10 each side on that lift chop, folks. 10 each side. Matter of fact, when you get back to that tall plank, MC, let's reach across and touch the hip today instead of touching your shoulders, just to mix it up a little bit and give you a slightly different challenge. There you go, Jay. That's it. Looking good. Yeah, so we're swinging that dumbbell pretty tough, but you're fighting that twist and real slow on our bicycle crunches. You got it. You got it. All right. Rest. We got 1 minute to rest. And then we're going back into it. Good job, folks. Feel free to flip over, go into a cobra stretch, stretch those abs out a little bit if you need to. Sideways, backwards roll into gunshot. 30 seconds. Covered our clock up now. Got a little bit of time. 20 seconds left. All right, so we should be getting set up for your low plank for 1 minute. And go. Let's get it, let's get it, let's get it. So we're just going 1 minute straight. Holding that plank. Remember, you're going to tuck that tailbone between your legs. So you're almost going to feel like you're rounding your back a little bit. When you do it, though, we don't want that butt to lift up in the air or lift up higher than normal. Great job, everybody. Got a little bit less than 30 seconds left on this one. Come on, you got this. I know you're getting tired, especially on this second round. Dave Whiteley, what's up, buddy? Hold tight, 5 seconds. And flip over right into the 10 world's greatest sit-ups. Looks good, everybody. Looks good. Come on. Remember, we're slow on the bicycle crunches. Time under tension. Keep rocking. Remember, once you get that lift chop, there's no movement through that torso. Resist the twist. You got it. You got it. So we are past the 1 minute mark. We got less than a minute left, and then we're going to get into our stretching for the day. What up? Oh, yeah? Keep going, guys. Keep going. 30 seconds left. You get done with those lift chops, go right in to see if you can crank out 10 of the world's greatest. Got 15 seconds left. You can crank out 10 in 15 seconds. You got to turn on the heat. All right, rest. We're gonna flip right over and stretch those abs out and go into a cobra stretch. So let those hips sink on down. Press up onto your hands if your shoulders are tired. You can always drop down your elbows. Remember, our focus here is our breathing. So big breath in through that nose, allowing that belly to expand, and you'll feel quite a bit of a stretch on those abdominal muscles. And that is what we're going for. There you go, just breathe. Feel free to bring the head up. Sometimes that'll increase that stretch across the front. See you, Whiteleys, getting fancy. All right, we're gonna go into a hurdle stretch. So crank one leg behind you, one leg out in front, and we're gonna try to grab those feet. So get a hold of some toes. There you go. Just hold and breathe. Hold and breathe. All right, let's go ahead and switch legs. See some of y'all laying down on your leg like that, looking flexible. All right, folks, that's it for today. Great job.